Don't worry, this is not an alien attacking me. It's just an extremophile. Extremophiles are rugged life forms that survive under extreme conditions. Yikes! They can be found in places like the Atacama Desert in Chile, which is the driest desert on Earth, or the bottom of an ocean in a vent of an underwater volcano. These extreme environments can help us understand how life may have formed on other worlds too. Wonder where else they can be found and why NASA is on the hunt to find extremophiles?
When we study extremophiles here on Earth, we're looking for environments that push the limit or the edges of physical or chemical parameters that define an environment. We also go to places where the acidity is very high. So places like acid mine drainage, where very high acid waters come out of environments where we've done mining. We're also interested in high pH, and we go to places like Soda Lake, some of the lakes that are in the Sierras in California. We're also interested in extreme salinity. So we go to places like the Great Salt Lake, which has the salinity that is probably 10 to 100 times the salinity of seawater. We're also interested in organisms that could withstand radiation that's thousands of times higher than the radiation that would kill a human being. Because of NASA's exploration of our solar system, we know that there's a diverse array of environments in our own solar system. Now, we're interested to know if those could support life. So NASA supports research to go into what we call analog environments. Those are environments that very much mimic the environments that we might find on Venus, which is very hot and acidic, the environment we might find on Mars, which is very cold and dry. And so we're interested in understanding the potential for life in any of these environments, because that will let us know if it's a place worthy of our search for life in our solar system.
So, if we know these types of extremophiles can live here on Earth in extreme conditions, do you think there could be organisms living on other planets in those extreme conditions?
NASA's interested in understanding the origin and evolution of life here on Earth so we can understand where else in our solar system or beyond life could exist. So one of the ways we go about this is to learn as much as we can about life here on Earth, and that really focuses on what we learn about extremophiles. Then we look at other bodies in our solar system and look at what kind of environments they present that could host life. So if we look at Mars, it's a lot colder and a lot drier, so much less water on Mars than here on Earth. So we go to places like the Atacama Desert to try to understand what kind of organisms can live in that cold, dry environment, and then hope that that will guide us in our search for life on Mars.
When we're looking for life on other planets, we need to stop thinking about what's normal for us. Instead, think about what's normal for extremophiles. If you want to find out more, check out this astrobiology website. See you next time.